Hello, we are on Grace Khan Academy and you are welcome. We are going to see different formulas that are used in probability. This is our video today. Make subscribe, comment, share and like for more videos. So as I said, it is formulas used in probability. So here, let's see different formulas that are used in a probability, but the first one that is for probability and statistics as the formula in general. So let us starting from what we call permutation. So in a probability we have what we call permutation, and the formula of calculating from permutation for the given number, it is P n to n, which is equal to n factorial. So this is the first one, and for there is a time when we have P n to R, this the formula of calculating this permutation is n factorial, then divided by n minus R, then what we call factorial. This is the first formula that are used in calculation of permutation. Let us see another formula used in probability, and that is what we call combination. For the part of combination, so we have sign looks like this, which summarizes combination R to n. So the formula, this will be equal to n factorial over R factorial times n minus R, this is the formula of calculating combination in probability. So again, in probability, that is what we call probability events. Probability events. In probability events, so we have probability events. This is it. Sample space, the probability of sample space is equal to n number of sample space, then divided by also number of sample space. So here this sign stands for sample space. Then there is also what you call complement of events. This is what we call probability events. Then let's see what we call complement event. For the complement events, we have probability E complement, which is equal to 1 minus probability of A. This is what we call about complement event. So simply means probability of A plus probability of A complement is equal to 1. This is all about complement events. So also we have to see these ones. This formula, which is if we have probability A union B, this is equal to N number of A union B divided by number of sample space. So if you have probability of A times the probability of B, so the probability of A union B, if you have probability of A and B, then this will be equal to probability of A plus probability of B, then minus probability of A intersection B. For instance, is this formula is applied when you have the probability of A and the probability of B. This is where you apply this formula. So let us see the next one. So the probability of A union B is equal to probability of A minus probability of B. Then, sorry, here it is a plus, then minus probability of A intersection B. This is the formula used to calculate probability of A union B. So here the probability of A intersection B is equal to probability of A then plus probability of B then minus probability of A union B. So this is the formula. If you have the probability of A and the probability of E, you can find probability of A union B and the probability of A intersection B. So let us see the next formula. Here, if you have we are looking for, if you have the two events, then if you have three events, probability of three events, probability of A union B union C. This is three events. This will be equal to probability of A plus probability of B, then plus probability of C, then minus probability of A intersection B, then minus probability of A intersection C. So this is the formula of calculating probability of A union B union C. It is equal to probability of A plus probability of B plus probability of C minus probability of A intersection B, then minus probability of A intersection C. So there is what you call mutually exclusive. Mutually exclusive for any probability. If you said mutually exclusive, A occur and B can occur but not at a go. We have A can occur and also B can occur but not at a go to the same time. So this is what they call mutually exclusive. There are different formulas that are used in mutually exclusive. For this formula is includes here, if you have A intersection B is different from the empty set, and the probability of A intersection B is equal to zero. And here you have to know that the probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B in mutually exclusive. So is what you call another formula used in probability, and it is what you call conditional probability. Conditional probability in conditional probability, we have A and B, and probability of A given by B has occurred here, and probability of A given B has occurred. Here, there are different formulas that are used in calculating conditional probability. And here, probability of A given B is equal to probability of A intersection B divided by probability of B. This is how you calculate the probability of A given B in conditional probability. And the probability of B given A is equal to probability of B intersection A, then divided by probability of A. This is how you calculate the probability of A given B and probability of B given A. So continually in this conditional probability, we have probability of A intersection B in conditional probability. It is equal to probability of A given B, then times the probability of B. And probability of A intersection B is equal to zero if probability of B given A is equal to probability of B n A intersection A, then divided by probability of A. Okay, so this is all about conditional probabilities. Let's see all about independent events. For the independent events, in these ones we have probability A given B, which is equal to probability of A, and the probability of B given A is equal to probability of B. This is in independent events. And also we have probability of A intersection B in independent event is equal to probability of A, then probability of B. In independent event, probability of A intersection B is equal to probability of A times probability of B. And the probability of A intersection B intersection C is equal to probability of A, this is C, is in C event, times the probability of B and times the probability of C. So here let us see also about tree diagram. In a probability tree, for instance, you have the events, for instance, in tossing a coin, you have to find the head or tail. If it is a coin, you have to find two possibilities, head and tail. For getting head and tail also, you have to toss another head, then tail. So this is what you call probability tree. So here in probability tree, what you have to know, there is a probability of getting a head, three head, it is equal to probability of head. So probability of getting tail, it is equal to probability of this one. And also probability of getting two heads, TZ looking like this one, and so on. So this is all about probability tree. Let us see what we call exhaustive events. Exhaustive events is also where you have E and NE, which is the empty set. Then probability of A in exhaustive event, it is equal to probability of A intersection E, then plus probability of A intersection EN E2, sorry, and dash continue, then to probability of A intersection EEN. This is all about an exhaustive event. So also again in exhaustive event, if we have probability of A, this will be equal to probability of E I, where I is from 0 up to N intersection A, then divided by probability of A. Okay, here E I is equal to E1, E2, E3 up to E N. Okay, you can use also the sign of summation in these exhaustive events, where you can say that the summation of I, which is equal to 1, then N, probability of E I, N A. Okay, so in also probability, there is what we call Poisson distribution. There is also what we call Poisson distribution. In Poisson distribution, the formula for calculating this one is x mean, which is to x value, then which is equal to nu for x e power minus nu, then divided by x factorial. This is the formula of calculating Poisson distribution. So again, another formula used in statistics and probability, in the part of Poisson, there is what you call expectation in Poisson distribution. The expectation Poisson distribution is equal to sum of x, which is equal to 0. Here there is infinite. Sorry, let me repeat again. And the expectation on the Poisson distribution is equal to sum of, here there is infinite, x which is equal to 0, then x nu power x e power minus nu, then divide by x factorial. This is how calculate the expectation on the Poisson distribution. So for the part of variance on the Poisson distribution is equal to expectation x minus nu, then squared cross. This is how calculate variance in the Poisson distribution. This will be equal to also if rate expectation of x minus nu, then squared. This is same as to be writing expectation of x square minus expectation of x, then squared. Okay, so this is what we call how calculate expectation on the Poisson distribution. Let us see about the the sacred random variables. In the sacred random variables, in the sacred random variables, here we have x in sample space, which is also in R. It is valued in R, and here the sample space in X is equal to its definition. X as element of real number such that probability of X is totally different from zero. So this is the definition of lambda x. So here the probability of B in the sacred random variables is equal to probability of A then plus probability of B given A. This is the formula of calculating probability of B. Then probability of A less than or equal to x less than or equal to b is equal to integral from a to b of the function given f of x then d dx. This is how calculated probability of a less than b less than x sorry less than b. So this is how calculated the expectation on the discrete random variables. The formula of calculating expectation and the discrete random variables, it is looking like this. E of x, or expectation of x, is equal to summation of then a x I probability of x, it is equal to x I. So this is equal to also summation of I then x I then f of x I. Okay, this is the expectation of the discrete random variables. The formula used in calculating expectation of the discrete random variables. So let us see on the continuous random variables the formula that are required to be used. Continuous random variables. For the continuous random variables, its expectation, it is equal to integral from infinite to infinite x of the given function f of x then dx. This is the formula of calculated expectation of the continuous random variables. So there is also another formula that I used to calculate variance in the continuous random variables, and this is equal to expectation then x minus expectation of x bracket squared then cross. This is the formula of calculating variance in the continuous random variables. There is also a formula of calculating standard deviation where it is equal to expectation of x squared then minus bracket expectation of x then in general squared. This is how we calculate standard deviation in the continuous random variables. So here in continuous random variables, there is even different function. How you can have f of x and g of x at a go. Its expectation of g of x can be equal to integral from infinite to infinite g of x, then f of x, then dx. This is the formula of calculating expectation of g of x. And here, if we have, for instance, a function plus the constant, its expectation Rx plus S s as a constant, it will be equal to error expectation of x 10 plus s, and its variance, it will be of error x plus s is equal to error squared, then variance of x. These are the formulas that are used or applied in continuous random variables for calculating the expectation for the given function, two functions, and if we have a function with a constant, see, its formula for calculating expectation is this one, and for the variance is this one. So, we are still on the formulas used in statistics and probability. I'd like to invite each and every person who is watching this video to make subscribe, share, comment, and like, such that he or she can be ready to understand each and everything. For the next video, we discuss about covariance and correlations in the general. So let us stop from here and see you next video. Thank you very much.